festival was over and the boys were all planning for a fall. Cabaret was quiet, except for the drilling in the wall. Curfew had been lifted and the gambling wheel shut down. Anyone with any sense had already left town. He was standing in the doorway, looking like the Jack of Hearts. He moved across the mirrored room, set him up for everyone, he said. Then everyone commenced to do what they'd been doing before he moved their heads. He walked up to a stranger and he asked him with a grin, "Would you kindly tell me, mister, what time the show begins?" He moved into the corner, face down like the Jack of Hearts. Backstage, the girls were playing five cards, stud by the stairs. Lily had two queens and she was hoping for a third to match her pairs. Outside, the streets were filling up and a window was open wide. The gentle breeze was blowing, you could feel it from inside. Lily called another bet and drew up the Jack of Hearts. Big Jim was no one's fool, he owned the town's only diamond mine. He made his usual entrance, looking all so dandy and so fine. With his bodyguards and his silver cane and every hair in place, he took whatever he wanted to and he laid it all to waste. But his bodyguards and his silver cane, they were no match for the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary combed her hair and took a carriage into town. She slipped into the side door, looking like a queen without a crown. She fluttered her false eyelashes and whispered in his ear, "I'm sorry, darling, that I'm late," but he didn't seem to hear. He was staring into space over at the Jack of Hearts. "Well, I know I've seen that face somewhere," Big Jim was thinking to himself. "Maybe down in Mexico or a picture upon somebody's shelf." But then the crowd began to stamp their feet and the house lights did dim. And in the darkness of the room there was only Jim and him, staring at the butterfly who just drew up the Jack of Hearts. Lily was a princess, she was fair-skinned and precious as a child. That certain something was a kind of a flash every time she smiled. She'd come away from a broken home, had lots of strange affairs with men in every walk of life who took her everywhere. But she'd never met anyone quite like the Jack of Hearts. The hanging judge came in unnoticed and was being wine and dine. Drilling in the wall kept up, but no one seemed to pay it any mind. It was known all around that Lily had Jim's ring, and nothing could ever come between the Lily and the king. No, nothing ever could, except maybe the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary started drinking hard and seeing her reflection in the night. She was tired of the attention, tired of playing the role of Big Jim's wife. She'd done a lot of bad things, even once tried suicide. Was looking to do just one good deed before she died. She was gazing to the future, riding on the Jack of Hearts. Lily took her dress off, buried it away. As your luck ran out, she laughed at him. "I guess you must have known it would someday. Be careful not to touch the wall, there's a brand new coat of paint. I'm glad to see still alive and you're looking like a saint. Down the hallway, footsteps were coming for the jack of hearts. The backstage manager was pacing all around by his chair. There's something funny going on. I know I can just feel it in the air. He went to get the hanging judge, but the hanging judge was drunk. A monk, but there was no actor anywhere better than the Jack of Hearts. Lily had her arms around the man she dearly loved to touch. She forgot all about the man she hated who hounded her so much. I've missed you so, she said to him, and he thought she was sincere. But in the hallway he felt jealousy and fear. Just another night in the life of the Jack of Hearts. Well, no one knew the circumstance, but they say it happened pretty quick. The door to the dressing room burst open and a cold revolver clicked. And Big Jim was standing there, you couldn't say surprise. Rosemary right beside him, steady in her eyes. She was with Big Jim, but she was leaning to the Jack of Hearts. Two doors down, and the boys finally made it through the wall. They cleaned out the bank safe, said they got off with quite a haul. And in the darkness of the riverbed, they waited on the ground for one more member who had business back in town. But they couldn't go no further without the Jack of Hearts. Well, the next day was hanging day, and the sky was overcast and black. Sober, Lord, he hadn't had a drink. And the only person on the scene missing was the Jack of Hearts.